Hello everyone, this is Hadrian. Thank you for being here. Let's play some more Subnautica in our Survival School series. So we are on episode 6 of Survival School, and seeing as how at the end of the last episode I was talking about how this base is a little bit far out and we might have to establish a second base that's maybe a little bit closer to the safe shallows, and this base perhaps will be a distance base, you know, kind of an outlying or satellite base, if you will. We need to focus this particular episode on finding some faster transportation. I've got my batteries charging right now, and I actually might take one or two of these partially charged batteries with me just to make sure that I can get where I need to go. But I would like this episode to get the mobile vehicle bay. We just need one more piece of it. And then once we have that, we, of course, just by sheer luck, I wasn't meaning to go after these pieces earlier in the series, but I happened to spot three of them, and now you only need three instead of five. We're also going to go ahead and go for the Seamoth this episode. So, no time to waste. Let's go ahead and take a couple of batteries here. They're exactly at 50% charge. So, you know what? Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and take all of these batteries, because 50% charge is better than none, and I'm going to put some of the no-charge batteries into charge while I'm gone. Looks like it might be getting dark. By the way, you probably saw this while I was looking at it, but just to point it out, if you ever have not fully picked up a given technology and you want to check your progress on how far along you are towards having that tech, you can always just open up your inventory with Tab, go over to the Blueprints Tab, and as you can see, we're 2 out of 3 on the mobile vehicle bay. So, let's head back towards the base. I'm going to try and avoid that stalker. Actually, there's a wreck right there, and wrecks are a place that we need to visit. So tell you what, let's jump back in here real quick and see if... Hey there. Leave me alone, please. The reason wrecks are a place we need to visit, well, we can't visit them right now because we need air. The reason wrecks are a good place to visit are that they are most likely going to be the location where I find this remaining piece of the mobile vehicle bay. So it's just a matter of swimming down in here and seeing what I can locate. Now it seems like there's something going on here, so let's... Oh, this is making me nervous. There's a little bit... Alright, here's a floodlight, which is good to have. We'll go ahead and scan this. That's gonna take a while to scan, and I'm gonna have to get the heck out of here because I don't currently have a way out. I can cut my way out once I have the proper tools, but right now I don't have that. Alright, and I don't see anything else in here. Yep, I need to get out. And quickly. So let's do that.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Another thing we're probably going to do very quickly. Alright, so there's nothing in that reef, but let's head back towards... Let's head back towards this. Another thing we're going to do very quickly is we are probably going to build a second oxygen tank. I received a few comments about this, and I am aware that it is kind of annoying that I was having to surface so much. Plus, you know, the computer narrator, this game's version of Module Barrett Roddenberry, really just... Did they update? It seems like they updated the burning ship. It looks a lot more detailed. But it just seems like she was interrupting me a lot. It's like this game's version of Star Trek's computer voice, is what I was trying to say. So I will probably go ahead, just to be on the safe side, I'll go ahead and get... Come here, Peeper. I need you. Thank you. Sweet! Now that pops up properly whenever you grab fish for the first time. So yeah, we're going to get a new air tank so that we can have a little bit more time. I don't typically do that in Subnautica, to tell you the truth. It's not usually necessary. You can get the modification station pretty quickly, which we're going to do in a few episodes most likely, presuming that we can find it. And then once you have the modification station, you can make a bigger single air tank without having to make a second one. Yeah, I feel like they've updated the Aurora. That just looks pretty. Here's another Peeper. Let's grab that thing. So I think I believe that I started saying a moment ago that we are in fact playing on a new patch. The Dangerous Creatures update. Hey, Dangerous Creatures update came out just a few days ago. So more new content to explore, more new stuff I haven't seen before. There are some new creatures and evidently some that I might even run into in the shallows. Did they fix the water problem? Yes, they fixed the water problem. Good. That was in desperate need of fixing. So no more water coming through the floor here. That has been resolved. So now that we are back, let's first go ahead and cook, because we did catch a couple of fish. Oh, wait. Don't need to cure anything. We're going to eat these right away. So we're going to do this. And then very quickly, we need to make a second air tank, which again, I don't always do because it takes up inventory space. And I frankly find it obnoxious. But for the purposes of a tutorial and not being interrupted constantly until we have a better air tank, a second O2 tank, I think, will come in handy. So let's remind ourselves of that recipe really quick. The equipment is glass and 2 chunks of titanium. Now, do I still have anything waiting for me here? I do not. I have 1 piece of titanium, though, so I just need to get some glass. Let's look around for some quartz. Again, pops out nice and bright at night. I'll go ahead and... Oh, hey, what's this? Solar panel fragment. Oh, wait, actually, you know what? I can use that for the other titanium that I need. Of course, since I already have the solar panel, boom, instant 2 titanium. Pointed this out earlier in the series. Whenever you need additional titanium, just find a fragment. Or if you see a fragment and you need titanium, I guess is the way I should say it. Then, okay, there we go. There's some quartz. Then you can, perfect. Scan that for an instant 2 titanium. It's very handy. I am so glad they fixed the water issue. All right. All right, let's make our glass, and now we're gonna have our second air tank. You're gonna see a nice jump in our swimming capacity. You're gonna see a nice drop in our inventory capacity. There we go, 105. Yeah, so we have 4 spaces less now. It's not terrible, but I want to try and do better if I can. Now, the only other thing I'd like to do, if I can, is maybe try and get a little bit of water in me. So let's look around. Do we see any air sacs? Look for any... Hey, there you go. There's a couple of them, actually. All right, try to keep these 2 in my frame of view. Okay, no chop, please. Thanks, game. Can't wait till Subnautica is a little bit better optimized. Oh, I'm so glad that the creature discovery screen shows properly now. That was added in the last patch, so it was in the game when we were playing the first several episodes, but now that the game's been patched again and some of these things have been fixed, it's even better than it was before. Oh, wait, no. Not gonna cook it. Just gonna get some filtered water out of this deal. And now that our stats are gonna be in better condition, time to go hunting for the other pieces of the mobile vehicle bay. And then it's just a matter of finding a bunch of resources in relatively quick fashion. So, let's have a look around. I do believe we can go this way for one of the wrecks that we can visit. So let's do that. I do not see anything here technology-wise. Wait, what's that? That trash can. I don't need a trash can, but it's scannable, so it's a decoration, so I'll use it. Notice that we now have a lot more air given that second tank, so we'll be interrupted a little bit less. Again, typically not necessary in my experience. You can do it if you want to. It's a nice gameplay option, and so I appreciate the commenters who brought that up, because frankly, it was starting to annoy me. By the time I got to the end of the last episode, I had made a note to go ahead and take care of that. So, speaking of oxygen, let's go ahead and hit the surface real quick, because we just found one of the wrecks, and this might be the only one we need to visit. Also, we're about to run out of power on the Sea Glide, so we're going to need to use one of those replacement batteries, which is just fine by me. Alright, back down we go. Straight down, in fact. Towards that wreck. Change power source. Okay. Now, I can't remember if I've already visited or fully scavenged this wreck yet. So this is going to be just a matter of looking around and trying not to get attacked. To a certain extent, I can't really avoid it, as you saw there. All right, I don't see any pieces of the mobile vehicle bay here. Ooh, that was some thunder outside. That was, if you heard that in the recording, Yeah, I'm playing during a bit of a thunderstorm. It's not a very bad one. The worst is past, but that was some thunder. Can't stop it when it's that loud. All right, let's go back up because we are below 100 meters.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
So now I'm trying to think of where there might have been other wrecks. This could be a little bit hit or miss. I'm going to try and get the last piece. We just need one piece of this thing. Let's go ahead and consume one of our first aid kits. I believe I've already visited that life pod. Alright, well, tell you what, here's what we're going to do. That's a whole nother biome down there. Those caves lead to another area that we will be exploring quite soon, because that's one of the places where we can get the multi-purpose rooms. Ah, got away from him just in time. Alright, so we're going to go for one of the other... Wow, there's... Holy mother of God! That's a lot in one place. I've never seen that many in one place. Alright, so what we're going to do is go for one of the other potential areas where this thing could be. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna turn my light off too, so I consume less power with this thing. And so, where are we going? First of all, where's the... Alright, there's the life pod. Yeah, we're gonna head this direction. The Blood Reef was in the general direction of the other... It's actually called Blood Kelp, if you want to get really technical. Blood Reef, Blood Kelp. There's some terrain pop in there. But this is the other grassy plateau that we struggled to find in the opening of the series because I was exploring, well, I was exploring the one that I just went through, as a matter of fact. I'm going to grab that bladderfish real quick. And there's another one. I'm going to grab that one too. Or am I? It's going to swim away at the last second. There we are. All right, so now where... There's the Blood Reef sign. All right, so we're going to go this direction because there's some more wrecks this way. And all we need is one piece of this thing, and then it's just a matter of collecting all the resources to put this thing together, which can be daunting the first time you do it. But once you have the hang of just kind of making yourself a list and knowing where you need to go, you will surprise yourself. You really will. All right, I think this is a Blood Reef entrance right here. Yes, it is. Very good. All right, here's actually a technology area right here. There could potentially... Hey there. Not a good time for that to die, but you know what? We're near the surface. I'm actually going to put that away. I don't want to waste battery on that while we're so close to the surface.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Alright, that's nothing of consequence. Solar panel fragment. Oh, I'll go ahead and scan it. The extra titanium with surface real quick. Again, I'm going to put my tool away so I can swim a little faster. And it looks like we're going to keep exploring in this direction. We'll be lucky if we get the Seamoth this episode. We really will. Just because it's taken a bit to find our way to these other pieces. I want to see what technology this belongs to. It's probably just a solar panel fragment. Yep. Because it's still in the shallows. You can kind of tell where different technologies are going to be after a while. I'm not saying that I could just divine what that was going to be. But as you can see, you can predict it with a reasonable level of accuracy. You won't always be right. But sometimes you will be. Oh, they changed the terrain here. I remember building a base on that ledge once, and these hills were not this pronounced. So that's new terrain. That hill is a lot bigger than it used to be. I like it. Alright, let's go ahead and get the sea glide back out, because we need to find a wreck. Bingo! I see some reef backs. Alright, here's what we're going to do. We're going to head up to the surface, and then, of course, we're going to go straight back down. All right. We have enough battery, I think, to... See, my only worry is that this is the wreck I already visited, and I don't know that I'll be able to find the other fragments here. But I'm going to try. By God, I am going to try. Put this thing up until we actually see a tech we can scan. This is a giant wreck. I'd be shocked if I didn't find anything here. Can I open this? No, it's locked. Alright. We What if I come in here? Okay, yeah, there's this little zone here. Can I open this? No. Notice I do have more swim time. Alright, I can't open this. We're gonna open this door. I'm gonna have to go up pretty soon. But at least kind of poking my head around for a second and seeing if there's a fragment of the mobile vehicle bay somewhere. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining. Yeah, I gotta get out of here. Well, this is unfortunate. Sometimes in playing Subnautica, you can find your way straight to certain fragments. And they just kind of... I mean, it depends a lot on the random number generator that helps determine where these things are going to spawn. So sometimes you just find your way straight to them, and other times it's a little bit more effortful in terms of getting the fragments that you need. In this case, we just need one more, which is especially frustrating when you're looking around for just one thing and you can't quite find it. And I also don't have all the battery life in the world to support this sea glide, so I can't do what I'm doing right now forever. That's a piece of metal salvage. Okay. Well. Alright, I think I only have just one more battery. Which is not good. Not good at all. Alright, so we need to find the mobile vehicle bay. I'm convinced it is in one of these wrecks, but we need to head back to Base Camp Alpha right now, because it doesn't matter how many of these wrecks I find. Oh wait, hang on, this looks like a debris field I maybe haven't visited yet. I can find all the wrecks in the game. But if I don't have a battery to get home with this thing, it's going to take a lot longer to do anything. And ironically, we're doing this in the name of getting the Seamoth submarine so that we can actually travel much faster. Hey there. Man, he managed to get me even when I was swimming by with this thing, which is impressive. Credit where credit is due. So our base camp is in that direction. Alright, we officially have... What's happening? Why did I stop moving all of a sudden? That was really strange. I need to take a medical kit. I stopped moving. I didn't do that. That was not my doing. All of a sudden, I just wasn't moving when the battery gave out on that thing. And it should... I mean, I guess when you have it held out... Yeah, you can still swim because you're still kicking with your feet. So now we just need to get back to Base Camp Alpha, which is actually fairly close. Actually, it's already in view. Excellent. We have lots of batteries here that should, I would imagine, be fully charged by now. And we can look around here to see if there's another wreck nearby. Since we're at our base.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Why, thank you. Alright, very good. So we've got fully charged batteries here. Let's go ahead and remove that battery. I did that simply by loading up the exchange power source by hitting R. And I just mouse scrolled down to no power source. Took the battery out. So if you ever need a battery, you can actually take batteries out of your existing equipment. Fun fact. Alright, now let's go ahead and pop this new battery in, and we're going to keep looking. Okay, so here's some of... We're actually very near one of the mushroom forests, as I might have discovered in previous episodes. That's quite nice. But that's not where we need to be right now. We need to be here. Let's see if we can spot any wrecks that could potentially contain technology for us to scavenge. Hi there. Leave me alone, please. Thank you. All right. This is reminding me of a surprise stream that I did on the channel once. I never do any scheduled streams for any of my content because, frankly, you know, it's, with my schedule outside of the channel, it's quite enough just to produce the YouTube content. But when I have spare time, I will occasionally just start streaming on the channel for anyone that might be around to watch. And I played Subnautica once, and we just had a similar run of luck, bad luck, finding things in a short period of time. I was trying to get the Seamoth relatively quickly, and this is like history repeating itself. We got the Seamoth pieces, but we need this last piece of the vehicle bay, and it is just hiding in the worst way. Okay, here's some wreckage. This could be it. This could be it. Maybe. Or it might not be. We'll see. Let's go in here. I don't see any scannable tech anywhere.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
What happens if I scan the metal salvage? Okay. Nothing.
Caution, dehydration detected. Emergency, 10 seconds.
Oh, yes, I know. Remaining. That's why I am swimming to the surface. Haven't heard that interruption in a while. That's the luxury of having the second oxygen tank. But unfortunately, we don't have the luxury of quickly finding the Seamoth pieces. Well, no, we found the Seamoth pieces. It's the mobile vehicle bay that we can't quite find. So I actually am going to modify my search tactic a little bit before we wrap this episode. I've got a few more minutes. I just have a feeling if I look elsewhere, I might have better luck. I have occasionally found pieces of the mobile vehicle bay in the kelp forests, and granted that was a couple of patches ago, but I am gonna choose to believe that it is possible to still find the mobile vehicle bay fragments in there. Oh hey, there's a Reginald. This is your best friend right here, the Reginald. I'm glad that I am near some Reginalds where I'm currently set up. Alright, go ahead and get a new battery in here. Let me show you why the Reginald is your friend. Let's hop in here, use the fabricator. We're gonna cook, and we're gonna cook this Reginald. Sorry, Reginald. Look at that, 44. And we did catch some bladderfish, totally forgot about that. So let's go ahead and get some water out of that deal, because we need to. And then we're gonna take a peek right next door, because we have the potential to find the last piece of this tech if I look around momentarily. So let's have a look-see. Any tech in here should still hopefully jump out. I hope, because it just looks like another, you know, white box. Similar to a lot of the other tech that we've scanned. But then again, in the most recent patches, they have relocated some of the stuff to those wrecks. And we've already spent time looking through those wrecks. To no avail. So I want to see if perhaps, in the latest version of Subnautica, and this could be an instructive experience. Yeah, that's the phrase I was looking for. For you, even if we don't find the pieces this episode, because it's giving you an idea of what you can find where, and frankly, what you can't. Subnautica is definitely a game of learning by doing, and occasionally learning by Googling things. I only say that as a last resort, though. I really do think the game is at its best when you're exploring everything on your own. All right, we need to hit the surface real quick. This is another one of those times that I'm wishing... What am I swimming towards? Oh, hey, okay. This is new, or at least it might not be new, but hang on. This could be good. This is a giant piece of ship. Okay. Yeah, I could see this thing as like a silhouette. Okay. I am hopeful. What's this? Perfect! Perfect! We got it! Oh, okay, so you saw that, they actually have unique looks now. But this, take a look at this. This is an episode devoted to finding the mobile vehicle bay. In the current version of Subnautica, you're most likely to find, hey there, you're most likely to find the other pieces of the mobile vehicle bay in this giant piece of wreckage. And where is this giant piece of wreckage? Tell you what, let's swim to the surface and give you a little bit of a sense of place. It's a good ways away, actually. That's the back of the Aurora, and there's the life pod. So, yeah. All right, so we finally have the mobile vehicle bay. Let's take a second before we end the episode, because now, the next episode, this ended up, again, being an episode devoted to just finding that last piece. But in the next one, we will, because we know what we need to make. We will build the mobile vehicle bay, first of all, because we need to do that first. We need a titanium ingot, which is 10 pieces of titanium. We need some lubricant and a power cell. Power cells are very doable. So we're going to need to pay a visit to the kelp forest again and get a lot of that stuff out of the... I'm actually staying oxygenated right now, just even though I'm a little bit below the surface. That's kind of cool. So we are going to pay a visit to the kelp forest and get a lot of the creep vine seed clusters to get the silicone rubber and the lubricant. And then on top of that, we will then need to make the the Seamoth, which will require another titanium ingot, another power cell, more lubricant, and just a little bit of glass. So when you think about that, you know where to find all of those ingredients. It's just a matter of, if you need the titanium, find, let's see, you need 20 titanium, right, for everything we just did, and you get 4 titanium for each little piece of ship that you pick up, the little pieces of metal salvage. So that's just 5 pieces of metal salvage, and you're done. You've got all the titanium you need to build both the Seamoth and the mobile vehicle bay. And then the power cells, again, it's just a matter of building a simple battery. Let me show you those ingredients again. Actually, a couple of batteries, which are just copper and acid mushrooms, and then some silicone rubber. And the silicone rubber and the lubricant is all just from hoarding that creepvine seed cluster, like I did in the beginning of the series when we needed to make our initial equipment. So, next episode. Sorry I faked you out a little bit. I've done that a few times this series. But again, on my channel, I typically don't edit out content because I just don't think it's very authentic. I think that, I'm not necessarily trying to cater to people with shorter attention spans. So if you were able to learn anything from my finding my way around there and seeing where you can find pieces and where you can't, I hope it was helpful, because that is the purpose of not taking out any content. Sometimes playing these kinds of games, you're going to have moments where you're stumbling around trying to find things, and there is value in that to be experienced. Maybe not by everybody, and that's fine, but I particularly find value in it. So again, I will go ahead and cut this one here, and the next one we're going to put together. Oh, I'm losing oxygen now. There we go. In the next one, we are going to put together the Seamoth, and it's going to be awesome. Thanks very much for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you're not already. I upload new episodes in Survival School every day at 6 Eastern Daylight Time, which is GMT-4 for those of you not in the States. And of course, the channel is on half schedule right now, so that means that it's not going to be every day necessarily if you're watching this live. It's every other day, but normally the series comes out daily. And any series that I have on my channel, both at 12 and 6, I have daily content going. That's the status quo on the channel, and we'll be snapping back into that soon. So again, thanks very much for watching. Comments are always welcome. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you next episode.